हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ डॉक्टर प्रमोद बोकड़े फ्रॉम प्रियदर्शनी भगवती कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग। वेलकम यू ऑल इन दिस वीडियो ट्यूटोरियल सीरीज ऑन लेटेक। फ्रेंड्स, इन प्रीवियस वीडियोस वी हैव सीन हाउ टू राइट डाउन द सिंपल मैथमेटिकल इक्वेशंस इन लेटेक एनवायरनमेंट। नाउ इन टुडेज वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न हाउ टू राइट द वेरियस टाइप ऑफ मैट्रिसेस इन द लेटेक एनवायरनमेंट। सो फ्रेंड्स, इन मैथमेटिक्स वी आर हैविंग द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मैट्रिसेस। I will classify that matrices into the simple matrix, then matrices with some parentheses, then next matrices with brackets, matrices with words, matrix with braces, and matrix with the double words. So let us see what are these different types of matrices and how it looks in the mathematics environment. So for that I will having a simple document which I have created for practice. So if you see here, this is the PDF that I have created by using the LaTeX. So this matrix, that equation number 1, m is equal to 2, 4, 6, 8. This matrix is nothing but your simple matrix. We will see how to create these matrices. Then second matrix, this matrix A, which is numbered as equation number 2. This is nothing but the matrix with parentheses. Now then third matrix B, which is indicated by equation 3. This is nothing but the matrix with brackets. It is matrix with brackets. So you can say it as a B matrix. You can say this matrix with parentheses as P matrix. Now the equation number 4, which gives the matrix A, it is the matrix with words. So these vertical lines, they are called as the words. So you can say this as the matrix with words, and the command related to this is V matrix. I will scroll down. If you see here, the next is equation number 5. So this matrix, it is called as the matrix with braces. So these are called as the braces. So this is the matrix with braces. And the last one is, it is matrix with double words. It is matrix with two vertical lines. So it is called as the matrix with double words. Right? Now let us see how to quickly produce such a type of matrices in LaTeX environment. So for that I will quickly jump into the Tech Studio. Let me zoom it. So I have already created one document, article class. So I will directly start typing how to write down these matrices. So first matrix was our simple matrix. If you see here, I will implement this first matrix, which is matrix M, indicated by equation number 1. So this matrix is the 2 by 2 matrix. It has two rows, row number 1, row number 2, and it has two columns, right? So let us see how to write this matrix in the LaTeX environment. So for that, you have to write down, or you have to create the equation environment by typing this begin equation and end equation. Now we have to write the matrix A. So I will write down A, that is equals to. Now we have to write down the simple matrix. If you can see here, this matrix is a simple matrix. So to create a simple matrix, what I will type here, I will, in next line, I will create one environment which is nothing but called as the matrix environment. So I will write down this begin matrix command and I will double click it. So it will create the matrix environment. Now inside this matrix environment, we have to write down the elements of the matrix. Now how to write down the elements of the matrix? Now it has two rows and two columns. So let us go back again and see. Now the elements of this matrix are 2, 4, 6 and 8. In the first row we are having the two elements 2 and 4, and in second row we are having the elements 6 and 8. So now these are the columns of your matrix, and to separate the columns we have to use the ampersand. So I will write down the elements as like this. If you see here, the elements are 2 and 4. Now if you see here, I have inserted one ampersand sign. So this ampersand sign is nothing but your column separator. So if you have to write the next column, you have to again give the ampersand sign. But for as our example, we are having only the two columns. there will be only one ampersand sign which will separate the two columns. Now I have to write down the elements of the second row. So I have to go into the next row. I will say the next line. So that's why I will insert the double backslash. Now that double backslash will always give you the next line, right? So I will go into the next line, and below that I will write down the next elements. The next elements was 6 and 8. So I will write down 6 ampersand 8. 6 ampersand 8. So here in this case, inside this matrix environment, I have written the elements 2, 4, and in second row we are having 6 and 8. We can put a double backslash here, but that doesn't any mean if you are not writing the double backslash, because there is no next row. So there is no need to write down the double backslash in that case. So I have written this simple matrix. So I will go and execute this file and let us see what is the outputs. I will click on build and view. So it will compile this document and let us see what will be the output. So the output generated will be your PDF file, and that will be shown in the window right to this source code. So let us see this. This is excited. It is compiling. After compilation, you will get the output. If your source code will be having some errors, then definitely you have to first correct that errors, and then and only then you will get your correct output. So the process has excited normally. So after a few seconds, it is going to produce the output PDF document. So for this, we will see here what will be the output for this source code that we have written in this document. So just wait for it. Now, so if you see here in the output document, it has produced a matrix A, which has two rows and two columns, and whatever the elements we have entered here, it is correctly displayed into the output equation, and that equation, as it is the first equation, it is numbered as 1. So if you don't want this equation to be numbered, then you have to use the starred version of this equation that we have already discussed. Now let us go and let us produce the another matrix. The next matrix is the matrix with parentheses. That means instead of a simple matrix command, you have to use the P matrix. You have to use the P matrix. So let us go and see how we can create this matrix. So I will write down here backslash begin equation. So it will create the equation environment again. Now we require the B matrix. We require the matrix is named as B. So I will write down here B. So if you can see here, we have given the name, we have given the name as matrix A. So I will write down the same name here. If you require the another name, you can write the other name to this matrix also. So A is equals to. Now we require the matrix with parentheses. So the command for that is backslash begin P matrix. If you see here, I will write down only P mat. So it is giving you the suggestion. Backslash begin P matrix. So I will double click on it. So it will create a P matrix environment. Now in this P matrix environment, if you see here, there we have considered the example of 3x3 matrix. It has 3 rows and 3 columns. And again, we have seen that every column will be separated by the ampersand symbol. So what I will do here, I will go back and I will write down here the elements. The elements are A, B, and C. So each element in this matrix is separated by ampersand. Then the next row will be D and E and F. You can consider the other elements also depending on your requirement. I will again give the double backslash to go into the next row, and the next element will be G and H and I, ampersand I. So I have completed writing the elements of the matrix. Now here, instead of the matrix, I have written here P matrix. So P matrix will give you the matrix with parentheses. So I will go back quickly execute again and let us see the output. It is going to produce again the matrix A with parentheses, and that will be numbered as equation 2. So the process has excited. It is compiling. Just wait for some time. You will definitely get the matrix A with all the elements A, B, C, D, E, F, and so on with the parentheses. So process excited normally. So if you see the output PDF document, here it will be A is equals to, this is the matrix with parentheses, and it is numbered as 2. So it has correctly produced the matrix. Now the next matrix I will consider, the next matrix is matrix B, and this matrix B is with brackets. It is with brackets. So we have to use the B matrix command instead of now P matrix. And the elements I have taken as 1, 2, 3 up to 9. So let us go back. I will create the next equation environment. Now here I have given the name as B. The matrix is named as B. So I will write down B is equals to. Now I will produce, we require the matrix with brackets. So that's why I will write down here B matrix. So if you type BM also, so here it will give you the suggestion. I will double click on it. So it is going to produce the matrix environment, B matrix environment. Now simply here you have to enter the elements of the matrix. So we know how to enter the elements. So suppose I have the elements as 1, 2, ampersand C. So this ampersand, again I am repeating, this ampersand is used to separate the two elements in the matrix. So at the end I will put the double backslash to go into the next row. Then the next row elements are 4, ampersand 5, ampersand 6. So the elements of the second row I have written. Similarly, write the elements of the third row. So I will write 7 and 8 and 9. So here in this case, I have completed writing this B matrix. So let us go and build this PDF. So definitely, again, it will give you one matrix with brackets, which is named as B. And that will be numbered as 3 because we have this 3 different equation environment. So this is equation number 1, it will be numbered as 2, and it will be numbered as 3. So the process has excited, and in few seconds, if you see here, it has produced the output PDF document. So here if you see, it has given you the another matrix B with brackets, and that is numbered as 3. So in this way, you can create the simple matrix, matrix with parentheses, then matrix with brackets. Now the next matrix is matrix with words. So here in this case, I will consider the same elements. You can change the elements, or I will consider the example again. Now, the next example is the matrix with words. So it has 2 rows and it has 3 columns. So now how to write down this, that we will see here. Now I have considered here the different elements, A suffix 1, 1, A suffix 1, 2, A suffix 1, 3. How to write down the suffix for any variable, that we have already seen. So, but we require the matrix with words. So how to write down that one? So I will again go back and build the equation environment. Then inside this, I require one matrix, and that matrix we have taken the name as A. You can take any name. So A is equals to, then we require the matrix with words. So I will create the environment. So begin V matrix. So if you see here, there is command begin V matrix. I will double click on it. So it will produce the V matrix environment. Now we have to write down the elements of it. So according to our example, we are having 2 rows and 3 columns, and that elements are numbered as A suffix 1, 1, A suffix 1, 1. So A subscript 1 1. So as there are two characters in the subscript, we have to write down the two characters within the curly braces. So that will produce you A 1 1. In the next column, we require A suffix 1 2. So I will write down A suffix 1 2. Similarly, in the third column, we require A suffix 1 3. So I have written all the three elements in the first row. Then I will go into the second row. Then in second row, we are having A suffix 2 1. Then in the next column, we have A suffix 2 2. And again in the next column, we require A suffix 2 3. So I have written all the elements, as you can see here, A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23. So I have written all the elements, and I have written the command name as V matrix now, that is matrices with words. So I will quickly go and execute this, and let us check what will be the output. So definitely it will produce the matrix with words. So it is compiling. So wait for some time. So if you can see from the output document, here it has produced a matrix with words with all the elements that we have written here, and it is numbered as 4. So similarly, we can have, I will copy this now to save our time. I will copy this, Control C. Now I require the fourth matrix. If you can see here, the next example is matrix with braces. These are nothing but the braces. So how to create the matrix with braces? Simply you have to change, instead of this V matrix, I will write down capital B. So in the begin B matrix should be end with the capital B matrix. So here it will give you the matrix with braces. So I am going to create the third row also for it. So A underscore 3 1, then ampersand A underscore 3 2, ampersand A underscore 3 3. So it has 3 by 3 matrix. So we are having total 9 elements which are separated by ampersand. So here I have written capital B. So this capital B will produce the braces around these elements. So I will quickly go again and compile this. So it is compiling now. So the process has excited normally. So if you are seen here, this is matrix A with braces, and it has numbered next, right? Similarly, if I will put, instead of this B matrix, I will put capital V matrix. Capital V matrix. So it will produce the matrix with double words. It will produce the matrix with double words. Instead of making changes here, I will copy paste it. So here I will keep as it is. And I will copy this. And I will paste it here. So instead of this V matrix, now I will consider V matrix, capital V. Capital V stands for double words. So I will again quickly go and build this one. So it will going to produce a matrix with double words. I have not changed the elements of this matrix. Depending on your requirement, you can change the elements. You can write the numbers, you can write down the alphabets, you can write down the fractions, you can write down the exponential and anything, depending on the elements which you require in your matrix. So if you see here, process excited normally, and in the output document, it has produced the matrix with double words, right? So in this way, we have created the six types of matrices. Now let us see how to write the matrix equation. So for that, I will consider a simple example that I have taken here. So if you have seen here, I have the matrix A. So it is the summation of the two matrix. So here I will consider, this is the 3 by 3 matrix also, this is the 3 by 3 matrix. Now how to write such a matrix now here? So definitely we have to create the 2 B matrix environment and we have to add it. So let us go and see how to write down this equation. I am now randomly considering these elements in this matrix now. So here in this case again I will go and create the equation environment. Now here I will write down A is equals to. Now the first matrix required is nothing but your begin B matrix. That is, we require the matrix with brackets. This is the most commonly used matrix. So I will consider this example begin B matrix. Now I will write down the elements of this matrix. So let us consider, I will write down the elements 1 and 2 ampersand 3. In next row, I will write down 4 ampersand 5 ampersand 6. And in next row, I will write down 7 and 8. And let us consider, I will take last element as a minus 9. So I have created the first matrix. So it will give you A is equals to this matrix with bracket. Now we have to add the another matrix with this matrix. So I will write down plus and I will create the another matrix now. So backslash begin again B matrix. So which type of matrix you require, depending on that you have to select the environment. So here I have created the B matrix environment and here again I will write down the elements of the another matrix here. So let us consider, I will take, that is 9 ampersand 8 ampersand 7. I am taking these elements randomly. Suppose we require the fractions here also. So I will consider the fraction. Suppose I will take the element as 1 by 2. So fraction 1 by 2. This is numerator, this is denominator part. Then in the next column, suppose I will require 0.5. Then ampersand, the third element in the second row, suppose I will require something that is 4, suppose. So double backslash and I am going to create the third row elements now. So consider these elements as 6 ampersand minus 8 ampersand minus 2, suppose. You can consider any element. So I have written all the elements in the another matrix also. So now let us go and build. What I have done here, a matrix A is equals to, I have written the first matrix with the 9 elements, 3 by 3 matrix. Then I have added the next matrix and I have created the environment for another matrix and written some elements into that matrix. So definitely it will produce A is equals to some matrix plus the another matrix. So I will quickly go and build this document and just wait for the output to produce. It will take few seconds, it will approximately take 8 to 9 seconds to compile this document. So it is compiling. So see, if you see here, it has produced one matrix A is equals to, I have written the first matrix plus the second matrix. If you can see here, it has produced correctly. So in this case, in this way, you can also have the matrix equations. Depending on which type of matrix you have to use, depending on that you have to use the P matrix or B matrix or V matrix or capital V matrix or capital B matrix. So friends, I think you might have understood how to write down the matrix. So here in this video we will stop and in next video we will see how to write the mathematical equations in a group or how to align the various mathematical equations. So that we will see in the next video. So for the time being, let us bye bye. Thank you.